A Wall Street Journal article published yesterday reports the Vatican is using money from its main charitable arm to fill the hole in the Vatican's own administrative budget. According to the report, every year more than $55 billion from Peter's Pence collection goes towards the Vatican's budget deficit. One of Pope Francis' priorities since his election in 2013 has been to improve the Vatican's management and financial problems. EWTN News Vatican analyst Andrea Gaiaducci joins us from Rome. Andrea, welcome back to the broadcast. What is Peter's Pence and how was it developed?
Well, the Peter's Pence is a special collection that faithful from all over the world do for the Pope. It was developed back in 19th century when Italy, the Italian state, was trying to seize the pontifical state. There was a conqueror of the pontifical state. And so Catholics from all over the world, mostly from the US, started a collection to help the Pope. Before, the Pope had a pontifical state, so he could keep up the state with taxes, and in this way, he could keep up the work the church was doing. But without a state, without taxes, you needed some special collection. That's how Peter's Pence developed back in 19th century. And that's why Peter's Pence is now used both for the Holy See and the Holy See balance sheets and Holy See issues and for the poor.
Let's expand on that a little bit more. Andrea, I understand that 10% of the donations go to charitable works. So where exactly does the rest of the money go?
Well, the rest of the money go generally to the dicasteries, to the nunciatures. You need to keep all these institutions up. The nunciatures are, for example, the papal embassies that are all over the world. The pontifical diplomacy is a diplomacy with a number of 173 states, diplomatic ties with 173 states. And these nunciatures are there for the Catholics. You know, they mostly help the Catholics on the ground and wherever. And then the state is needed for the needs of the church because the Pope needs to be helped. And then, you know, all of this money are also invested so that you can have more money and you can use them for the poor. 10% of this is for special provisions for the poor or, as you know, for special needs. When there was the earthquake in Haiti, for example, or so on and on, the Pope generally sends his donation for the aids.
Well, while we're on the subject of money in the Vatican, how is this related to a recent investigation into the Vatican's real estate investment scandal where reports say it spent over $300 million?
Well, it was related to the Vatican investigation because the investigation was on a fund that was bought by the Secretary of State. The Secretary of State is the papal secretary. And so since the Peter's Pence is given to the Pope, is a special collection for the Pope, is the Secretary of State that handles this money and that invests this money. So that's why it was related with Peter's Pence. And that's why people started thinking why the Peter's Pence is used for investments. Actually, as the Pope said, coming back from Japan in the in-flight press conference, having money does not mean to have them in a drawer. You need to invest them. Charity is a professional issue, even for the Holy See, believe it or not. You know, it's not just about delivering money. It's mostly about making the profit with money and having more money to help the poor. So that's why there was this scandal, because mostly it was investigated the way this real estate, luxury real estate in London was purchased and how the intermediaries played a role into this purchase, which can happen. You know, sometimes you can have a mismanagement or bad investments, but we'll see if this is the case, because actually the operation was restructured. But the scandal was mostly scandal. The so-called scandal was mostly about that. While and it was about Peter Spence because the Secretary of State handles that.
Very interesting. Well, obviously, we with EWTN News are going to continue to cover the financial investigation and situation of the Vatican. Andrea Gaiaducci, Vatican analyst for EWTN News. Thanks so much.
Thank you.